Next up, we have Ms. Kriti Monga. Mr. Arjun Nath. Ms. Karthika V.K. Mr. Riaz Amlani, he'll be joining us soon. Finally, I'd like to request Dr. Yusuf Merchant to please escort Mr. Rahul Bose onto stage. Thank you to all our speakers for joining us today. Our first speaker of the evening is Ms. Kriti Monga. Kriti Monga is a graphic designer and illustrator from Delhi, an alumnus of NID. Her work, hand lettering, and travel and event diaries have been featured in several design and lifestyle publications. She has also set up Turmeric Design as an independent design practice focusing on producing interesting and meaningful design through active collaborations with other professionals and peers. Ms. Kriti, please. We could have a few words.
Hi, I'm beyond excited to see the book today. I just saw it a few hours ago, maybe about half an hour ago.
Thank you, Riaz. We have in our presence a noted actor and, according to me, one of the most enigmatic stage actors of our time, Mr. Dalip Tahil. We would request you to come up and give us your definition of happiness, what it means to you, how it's come up in your life.
Well, a very good afternoon to all of you, and it's lovely to see that you're all here. Thank you very much. Of course, at the outset, I would like to thank Dr. Yusuf Merchant for inviting me here. I had heard a lot about Dr. Yusuf. Most of it was kind of mixed, and a lot of it was very good. And his lovely wife, Sana, who's also been so hospitable. So thank you all very much for inviting me here. And of course, my dear friend, Anil Singh, who told me that, don't be filmy, come here absolutely on time or else. I actually beat him by 2.5 minutes. I was here 2.5 minutes earlier than him. But one of the good things about speaking almost last is that everybody has said what you wanted to say. And in the profession that I'm in, and of course, I'm sure that most of y'all as well in the urban situation in life and all the kind of pressures and things that we need to do to actually keep ourselves going in this highly competitive and sometimes cruel world. We've all, you know, at some point in time through a period of time, apart from, of course, Mr. Rahul Bose, who's, I don't think, needed any extra crutches to hang on to. But we've all sort of flirted with alcohol and with dope in our days. And, you know, we thought that was the way to happiness. It certainly seemed to be the way to chill out. Some of it helped, yeah. I mean, I'm not saying it was all bad, but it also needed to be addressed. And in those days, of course, there wasn't a Dr. Yusuf or people who really understood that perhaps you're having some sort of dilemma, or you need some sort of proper support. People just told you to get it together and give you a swift kick in the backside, which I'm told Dr. Yusuf does as well. But the fact remains that happiness is, as far as I can interpret it, happiness is very relative. I think that all of us in our lives are in the pursuit of happiness. I mean, we all want to seek happiness. Everybody wants to be happy. How we go about it, I think, is very sort of individualistic. It's very personal. And I just would like to say that I wish all of you in your pursuit a lot of success. And I just hope that there are many, many more happy people in this world. And I know that Dr. Yusuf is doing a great job towards that end. So having said that, a very good afternoon to you, and thank you very much, and have a good time, and be happy.
Thank you so much. Our next speaker for the night is Mr. Rahul Bose. He is one of the most versatile actors in Bollywood. He is also a screenwriter, a director, a social activist, and a rugby union player. His first movie was Dave Benegal's English August. It won the National Film Award for the best English film that year. Time magazine named him the superstar of Indian arthouse cinema for his work in parallel cinema films like English, August, and Mr. and Mrs. Iyer. In 2017, he directed, produced, and acted in the biopic Purna about the youngest girl to climb Mount Everest. He has also played at the Asian Rugby Football Union Championship as part of the Indian national team. He is also notable for his social activism. He participated in the relief efforts that followed the 2004 Boxing Day tsunami and is also the founder of an anti-discrimination NGO called The Foundation. Bose has given lectures on gender equality and human rights at Oxford and during the 2004 World Youth Peace Summit. In 2011, he worked in conjunction with Bhaichung Bhutia to raise funds for victims of the Sikkim earthquake. Please welcome Mr. Bose with a huge round of applause.
It's a half nice feeling to hear about yourself, and it's half embarrassing. I'm not quite sure which way, you know, that whole thing I lean. It depends from day to day. I have a confession to make. I don't know Dr. Merchant. I really don't. I'm here because Anil Singh, one of my dearest friends, asked me to have a look at the book. I'm very aware of his work for the last quarter of a century. You call it Land, D-A-I-R-C-C? RRC. Which I'm familiar with, and I remember all the seminal work he did way before it became fashionable to talk about addiction, both mental, emotional, drugs, all of that. When Anil said, this is the book and this is the cause, and I was like, okay, in that case, I'm definitely going to be here. But unlike Arjun and Riaz and all the others who've spoken, I actually don't have a first-hand relationship with Dr. Merchant, and I'm here because the book makes sense, and I think everything that everyone's spoken here is precisely aimed towards what that book is trying to say. Yesterday, I was having a conversation with a friend of mine, and she said something to the effect of, take noise-canceling headphones with you on the flight. I'm going to catch a flight to Australia tonight. Take noise-canceling headphones with you and go to sleep on the flight. And I answered, half-jokingly, that I have not had noise in my head for years. I just don't need noise-canceling headphones. But it has happened with enormous amounts of work. Neither have I been addicted to drugs or smoking or drinking or all of that. But as every artist is, there's a self-destructive streak in us artists. And I've had that and I've celebrated that on and off, but always understanding, without anyone telling me, that my role on this earth is to be more peaceful and more compassionate than yesterday. It's as simple as that. So towards that end, and I do a lot of talks all over the world to corporates and universities and things, about my life and about the lessons, leadership lessons, lessons of healing, lessons of success. And one of my talks is I start with the three greatest failures of my life, the three greatest humiliations, the three not cool stories to tell in public. So here are the three things that I know I have followed in my life to lead me towards peace, much more than happiness. Just an inner peace. And the first thing is, if you are prepared to lose everything, you will walk free. If you are prepared, whatever you do, just imagine a life if you lost it all, including the people you love. If I'm prepared to lose my sister and my niece and my acting career and my two foundations and the work I'm doing with the Indian Rugby Union, what will happen? Who will I be? How much money will I have? Where will I live? Who will be my friends? If that scenario is livable, if that scenario is enjoyable, you're through. You're done. The second one is, please learn to forgive yourself. We all make mistakes on a daily basis. Forgive yourself and never hesitate to ask for forgiveness. I have yet to meet a person who I have apologized to the next day or the next month or maybe 10 years later who has said, I don't forgive you. The universe will forgive you as long as you truly mean, as long as you truly are sorry and you will not do the same thing again. So forgive yourself and never hesitate to ask forgiveness from others. The third one is, find out what it is that gives you the greatest joy. It could be anything. It could be playing with your child. It could be walking on a rainy day on Marine Drive. It could be something far grander, deeper, and more important as fighting world hunger. Whatever it might be, make sure you'd make that your life. It might not be the earning part of your life. I have yet to see somebody who's become a millionaire walking on Marine Drive on a rainy day. It might not be the earning part of your life, but it has to be an inextricable part of your life. You have to dip into it again and again, because there you have found a pool of replenishment and self-affirmation that's free. And finally, learn from the past, prepare for the future, but live this moment. I'm here, Dr. Yusuf Merchant's book opening. I'm speaking, the others have spoken, the book will be launched. I'm here. I'm here and I'm present. And I'm living this moment. And thankfully, and I hope this is the truth for everybody in this room, if I drop dead right now, done. No, not a single regret of not having, my life has been full of regrets, but right now, at this point of time, if I was to drop dead, it would be a good way to go. Congratulations, Doc.
Thank you so much, Mr. Bose. Your lessons will stay with us for a long time. I'd now like to request Mr. Bose, along with Dr. Yusuf Merchant, to unveil the book, Happiness, Life Lessons from a Creative Addict. I'd also like to request the other speakers, you all have boxes in front of you all, if you all can open them and also showcase your books in front of you.
It's quite interesting. जो आप देख सकते हैं इसका स्पेलिंग भी कुछ अलग लिखा हुआ है. It's not the right. कौन सा कैमरा? तो कुछ अलग इसका स्पेलिंग है. तो यही इसकी मिस्ट्री है. तो इस मिस्ट्री को सॉल्व करने के लिए बुक को पढ़ना बहुत ज़रूरी है. डॉक्टर यूसुफ मर्चेंट से आज मेरा पहला इंटरेक्शन था एंड इट वॉज बैंग ऑन. और कहीं ना कहीं एक बुक बताती है कि आपको अपनी हैप्पीनेस को किसी चीज़ के साथ अटैच नहीं करना है कि अगर मेरी ज़िंदगी में वो हो जाएगा तब मैं जाके खुश होऊंगा. मुझे कार चाहिए, मुझे घर चाहिए, मुझे ये चाहिए, मुझे अच्छी गर्लफ्रेंड चाहिए, वट एवर एक्सपाइसी. तो आपकी हैप्पीनेस को किसी चीज़ से आप फिक्स मत कीजिए. वो ना हो तब भी आप बहुत खुश हैं. इस बुक में ये अभी शिव खड़ा की एक नई लॉन्च हुई है बुक, तो मैंने कल वो खरीदी है क्रॉसवर्ड जाके. और मैं काफ़ी नॉन फिक्शन ज़्यादा पढ़ता हूँ एंड आई थिंक इट बिलोंग्स टू दैट कैटेगरी ओनली. ये नॉन फिक्शन बुक है. फिक्शन में इतना शौक रखता नहीं. नॉन फिक्शन आई लव इट. अपकमिंग प्रोजेक्ट वेब सीरीज़ के लिए कुछ है और नथिंग इज़ कॉन्क्रीट, नथिंग इज़ फाइनलाइज्ड येट. संघर्ष चालू है क्योंकि कुछ भी नहीं कर सकता मैं. थैंक यू सो मच.
सब अलग अलग सेक्शन में भाग रहे हैं.
यार आप वॉल्यूम बढ़ा लो ना थोड़ा सा.
इस बुक के बारे में आप क्या कहेंगे हिमांशु?
इस बुक के बारे में बस इतना है कि खुश रहो और खुशी से जिंदगी जियो. इसका मतलब हैप्पीनेस है.
इसके बाद एक और बुक आने वाला है जिसका नाम होगा बियॉन्ड हैप्पीनेस. उसका भी हम प्रमोशन अभी से कर रहे हैं.
अगर आप इस किताब से खुश नहीं हैं तो शायद आपको दूसरी किताब पढ़नी पड़ेगी क्योंकि आप बहुत ज्यादा सुपर इंटेलेक्चुअल हैं. What kind of books do you read? I've never asked you that.
I like romantic stories, to be very honest.
I don't read them. That's a different ballgame, but it's nice.
Chetan Bhagat and all of that.
You read Chetan Bhagat? So cute.
Typical girly. But अभी बहुत ज़्यादा different type के ऐसे type के happiness वाले books पढ़ने की बहुत ज़रूरत है.
But you read fiction.
I am.
Fiction. Romantic stories. Sydney Sheldon and everything. Sydney Sheldon or something, do you read?
I used to.
Okay.
Abhi nahi. Okay. Now I'm recently reading that book. Should I forgot the name? Subtle Art of Not Giving Up. Whatever.
That's called The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck.
Yes.
That's the most common. It's an amazing book. Yeah. But that's not a fiction. That's a non-fiction.
That's not a fiction. Yeah,
but that is a very nice book. Yes.
I've started reading it. अभी मेरा एक शो खत्म हुआ शनि. एक महीना डेढ़ महीना ही हुआ है. सो थोड़ा सा ब्रेक लेने के बाद करेंगे यार. थोड़ा सा 3 महीना तो हक है.
वो भी उमरगांव जाके शूट करना है, वहाँ पे रहना, तो थोड़ा सा तो आराम करने दो यार. She's a pampered daughter of the mother, so I know she needs some break.
Unke haath mein na goodie box bhi, unko alag se goodie box mila.
Thank you.
Hum bhi soch rahe
goodie box. Does it have only the book? Does it have only the books and anything else?
I think the books.
How nice, thank you.
Fragile, mirror inside. अपनी शक्ल देखो। डेफिनेटली करना चाहूँगी, आप प्रोड्यूस करो, मुझे कास्ट करना।
यस, थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू, थैंक यू।
ये कहना चाहूँगा कि ऑब्वियसली वी गॉट अ कॉल, वी हैव कम इन अ फुल सपोर्ट एंड इट्स अबाउट द लाइफ एंड द हैप्पीनेस एंड यू नो एंड आई थिंक एवरीबडी नीड्स दैट इन लाइफ. द एंड ऑफ द डे व्हाट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग यू अर्न यू डू इन अ बिजी शेड्यूल, द हैप्पीनेस इज द ओनली थिंग विच इज मिसिंग इन एवरीबडीज लाइफ टू सम एक्सटेंट. सो आई थिंक दैट्स द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग एंड यू नो द काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रेसफुल लाइफ वी हैव एज एन एक्टर और एज अ टेक्नीशियन एंड एवरीबडी यू नीड दैट समथिंग टू डिस्ट्रेस. एक्चुअली रियल लाइफ में मैं वैसे बहुत ज़्यादा बुक्स में नहीं हूँ, बट आई ऑलवेज फील के समथिंग ऑन बेस्ड ऑन अ ट्रू स्टोरी और समबडी इज लाइफ स्टोरी और समथिंग रियलिस्टिक. डेफिनेटली सी हम लोग एज एन एक्टर मीडियम तो सारे हैं और वी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम मॉडलिंग टू एक्टिंग. सो आई फिनिश माई सी आई डी ऑब्वियसली फॉर सो मेनी ईयर्स एंड दी अदर सास बहु शोज आई हैव डन एक्शन. And recently I just went through Porus where I was playing a little elderly character, so I had put on 8 kgs of that. So right now I've cut down that 8 kgs and now I'm looking for something different, so I'll have a different look.
Yeah.
Definitely I've been getting calls for web series 2, but agar kuch sensible project aata hai, kuch sensible script aati hai, to definitely I'll go for that. But at the moment, what I'm getting is, I think, beyond my imagination also. Not that forward to go on a special sex thing. So it has to be something concrete. Thank you so much.
I think happiness is very important and Dr. Yusuf was talking about the soul happiness ki hamara soul khush hona chahiye aur wo batana chahte hain ki hamari khushi hum akele hain tab bhi hum khush kaise reh sakte hain, hum ameer hain ya hum gareeb hain ya hamare paas pyar hai ya nahi hai, hame khush rehna chahiye. To is book mein ye likha hua hai ki ye sab cheeze zaruri nahi hai, happiness is just a choice. Agar aap khush rehna chahte hain to aap khush rahenge, nahi to aapke paas sab kuch hone ke bawajood aap dukhi hain, what is that? To us sab ka saar hai wo is book mein hai ki aapko khush rehne ke liye kisi ki zarurat nahi hai, na pyar ki zarurat hai na maa baap ki zarurat hai, aapko apne andar dhoondna hai ki usse khushi kaise hoti hai. So it's like that. So un sab cheezon ka matlab hai is book mein, it is called happiness, कि हमें किसी की जरूरत नहीं है खुश होने के लिए. क्या रियल लाइफ में
किस टाइप की बुक रीड करना पसंद करती
है? मुझे सेल्फ ग्रोथ बहुत अच्छी लगती है जिससे कि मैं सीख सकती हूँ, बिकॉज मैं यूजुअली अपने मन की बात या अपने आप को एक्सप्रेस नहीं करती हूँ लोगों से, बिकॉज आपको पता ही है सारे लोग कैसे होते हैं आसपास के. सो या तो मैं फैमिली से बातें करती हूँ या मैं बुक पढ़ के सीखती हूँ, जो जैसे इस बुक के बारे में अगर मुझे पता, अगर मैं जानना चाहती हूँ कि व्हाट इज़ हैप्पीनेस, तो मैं किसी से पूछूंगी नहीं व्हाट इज़ हैप्पीनेस. मैं कोशिश करूंगी कि मैं ऑब्जर्व करूं आसपास या बुक पढ़ूं और उससे लर्न करूं. तो बेसिकली मुझे सेल्फ ग्रोथ की बुक ज़्यादा अच्छी लगती है. इस बार एक नई और हीरोइन आ रही है, ट्विस्ट है ट्विस्ट, और थोड़ा 3 months लीव ले लिया है इशबाज ने. सो काफ़ी कुछ होने वाला है, इनफैक्ट काफ़ी कुछ हो रहा है. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सो मच. हाँ हाँ चलिए सब वेरी डिफरेंट. एक सेकेंड जीना चाहते हैं. इट्स वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू फील हैप्पी एंड हैप्पीनेस इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टू अस. सो ऑब्वियसली इट वुड बी अ ग्रेट सक्सेस एंड ऑल द बेस्ट टू यूसुफ मर्चेंट. थैंक यू फॉर इनवाइटिंग अस.
आप किस टाइप के बुक्स रियल लाइफ में रीड करना पसंद करते
हैं? आई लाइक टू रीड दिस काइंड ऑफ बुक्स, फिलोसॉफिकल, साइकोलॉजिकल, ऑल्सो एट टाइम्स फिक्शन. प्रोजेक्ट्स के बारे में बहुत ही जल्दी आप लोगों को मैं दिखने वाली हूँ, कहाँ मैं नहीं बता सकती, बट बहुत ही जल्दी फॉर श्योर.
मैम आपको वेब सीरीज़ के लिए ऑफर्स आ रहे हैं, तो आप उस बारे में क्या कहेंगे?
यस, वेब सीरीज़ के ऑफर्स तो आ रहे हैं एंड आई वुड रियली लव टू डू अ वेब सीरीज़ अगेन, क्योंकि वेब सीरीज़ का मज़ा लाइक एन एक्टर उसमें काम करके मज़ा कुछ अलग ही आता है. सो या
कोई फाउंडेशन?
Not only about foundations, it's very creative. The way you think, it's more, much more realistic, creative. Aapka dimag aur broader and wider tarike se sochne soch sakti hai. So it's very creative. Thank you.